Hey yo, what's up YouTube? What's up my people? What's up my favorite subscribers? My name is Kolisa, and if it's your first time to the channel, welcome to Africa Listens. Hey look, today I'm gonna be checking out reacting on the AKA Momreal service and today this video that I'm gonna be listening to or reacting to is Sim Dope, AKA longtime friend, finally revealed. Now the reason why this caught my eye is because of the name Sim Dope in capital letters. Now AKA released a song called Sim Dope, and that song was fire. Like, that's one of my favorite songs ever made by AKA. And so I didn't know that this song was actually for someone, like it was the name of someone, or it was written for someone. I thought it was just a song, you know, that sounded good, and Sim Dope was just a title. I didn't even understand. I remember, like, listening to the song, I'm like, I love this song so much, but I don't understand what does it mean by Sim Dope. So Sim Dope is a person. Sim Dope is AKA's longtime friend. How cool is that to have someone with AKA's stature writing a song about you? You must be really special. So I'm excited to listen to this. So yeah, man, let's go, let's listen, let's jump. I couldn't find the video of Sim Dope, like, alone, like a good quality video of Sim Dope alone. So I believe this is from a reaction channel by It's All a Dream TV. As I see, I believe this is the guy here. And so he's also doing a reacting to. So I'm reacting to a reaction of Flip, how can I put this? So I'm reacting to a reaction of It's All a Dream TV's video, or from their channel. So this is crazy, but anyway, beauty of the internet, right? Beauty of the internet. He had it on his channel, so I mean, I'm gonna have to look at it, and I want to watch it since I cannot find it, and I don't have time to really go down deep the rabbit hole and trying to find Sim Dope's speech. So please bear with me, and I hope that It's All a Dream TV, my guy. I hope that you're all good. I hope that you don't take offense of me reacting to this video that you uploaded. Please, guys, go and subscribe to his channel. I think that he's a reactor, so, and he reacted maybe to, I think that he reacts to South African music. So please go and show some love. So yeah, let's go.
Things a little bit, I don't know. I feel him in me.
Shut up, man.
Kenan Forbes, 2000. The first guy I ever met was him at St. John's. He came from Cape Town, and here I was coming from Nelspruit. And it was so surreal this week. And we're at assembly, and Forbes, Kumete. And I'm like, who the Forbes, dude? And obviously, I'm looking for some white rich guy. And here comes this tall colored guy.
Doesn't mean.
Okay.
I've never.
So I'm sitting, we're standing in the queue next to each other. They assign us to classes.
YouTube is acting up today. I've never heard of a same name Forbes. I've never heard of Forbes. I know of the Forbes list, but I've never heard of anyone called Forbes, like with their last name called Forbes. So really, it's really cool. I don't know how they got that. His parents got that. I'm not sure, but amazing.
We you know, we're all sussing out the situation. You know, first time in private school, so it's heavy. And okay, our first class was Afrikaans. Okay, Afrikaans, we get into the class, the teachers walk us in, they say, everybody's gonna greet each other in Afrikaans, first day, greet each other.
First day, yeah.
But Kenan doesn't know Afrikaans well.
Oh, okay.
I definitely don't know Afrikaans.
Interesting.
So everyone starts the conversation. Oh, handed, what? Then it's me and his turn. So I'm standing there and I said to him, Vat op. And all the class break out laughing because it's up? A direct translation for what's up. So I'm there, vat op.
Yeah, yeah. It's a direct translation. And dude, that's like,
he just started
that?
Laughing. And we failed, obviously. But, you know, I'm not from the industry and music, and I'm just his friend. Since we were 11 years old.
No wonder we don't know
We used to walk to the Forbes' house every day to eat.
11.
And Uncle Tony used to play soccer with us and cricket. Steph, we used to call him Wayne Head. And I don't know what I'm supposed to say to you, but I can only tell you about Keenan, the person. He made it so cool just to be me. He made it so cool just
hey,
to
man,
be me.
Hey man, the guy wrote a song about you.
A lot of times people don't know that it's hard to carry things when you don't know. You know, I remember, in fact, let me tell you how this Slim Dope name came.
Okay.
So we get to grade 10. And I make the first team, the first rugby team. And now it's like a big thing for everyone. But for me and him, it's just, boy, no more picking up the dirt after the game. So we're sitting there and he says to me, Sim, I mean, now you're a boat, bro. I mean, like, you're a boat at school. So we laugh. And he says, but you can't go, I mean, on Saturday and just be Sim Piwe. I mean, that's not dangerous. That's not dangerous. So I'm saying to him, you're the lover boy who writes love letters and, you know. So he says, no, you're Sim Dope 11 now. I say, I mean, what are we going to do? He says, go to Facebook and write Sim Dope 11. So we start on this journey of Sim Dope 11. And I remember bumping into him and on Lynn and Rosebank just when Levels was about to drop. And we were standing outside the Shesha shop. And he's now telling me, yo, I just immortalized you, Mortal Kombat, Liu Kang, Sub-Zero. I'm like, yo, this guy, what's going on? He says, boy, your life is about to change, eh? So I say, okay, tell me. He says, no, I wrote a song, dog. About what? He says, about you and me, life and everything. So I said, no, you can't write a song, my brother. Are you crazy? I mean, who am I? And he says, boy, you meant so much to me and our journey. Then he reminds me to say, remember we went on a school tour to Australia in grade 6, I think.
Wow.
And so he was sitting next to me on the flight, and it's maybe like a 16-hour flight. We stayed awake the entire flight waiting to see Australia. And our first thing we know, we get there and we're the Kangaroos, yeah. I mean, crikey, you know, we're in that discussion. And he says to me, you know, Sim, you remember in grade 10, they weren't gonna let you write, they weren't gonna let you play the rugby match if you didn't pass the maths test on the Wednesday, I think it was. So I said to him, yo, don't talk about it. But I played that game because, you know, in the song, it talks about crib notes and all of that. In the test. So it was obviously Forbes, Kumete in the class spectrum. And he swapped our test tape papers. And he took the D and I took the B.
Wow.
You know, and
that's crazy. I mean, to admit to that, that's crazy, but I feel you, man. I mean, that's what the guy did for you. That's how much love he had for you. So I understand, but that's wow. I don't know if you can get Charles or Holt accountable for that now. Interesting. But hey, man, these are guys who knew each other for a long time, so who are we to judge?
He means so much to me because he made it so cool just to be okay. And I want to thank his parents for always welcoming us in their home. Even this week, watching the people walk freely around, it was just like in Houghton. It was just like that. And seeing Steph, bro, you're so strong. You're so firm. I know you're gonna be okay. Zintle, I'm lost for words for what you've done for Cairo and so much. Thank you. Aunt Lynn, you are probably the best granny on the planet. Uncle Tony, thanks for being our dad and fighting for us from 11 till now. Really, it meant a lot. I just want to say thank you to all of you for coming here and loving this boy. He meant so much to me. That a funny thing I noticed about most of you actually that would have made Forbes crazy here. A lot of you are wearing black sneakers, eh? Forbes hated black shoes. Every sneaker had to be white, fresh, pure. But thank you so much. We appreciate it. Long live, mega long live. I want to introduce the boys who brought the music with them. The dudes who wrote with them. Ivy League.
Oh, okay. All of these speeches, they are cut short, man. Like, they don't end. Like, where are the full speeches? Damn. But anyway, this was cool, man. This was beautiful to watch. I really enjoyed it. Matter of fact, let me go straight to... How long do I have? I have 10 minutes. Okay. Let me go straight to the song Seem Dope. I need to listen to that song. That song was fire. Seem Dope was fire. And now I need to listen now to the lyrics. Oh, this is a song. Is this a song? Maybe. Let's go. The fifth season. Seem Dope. I think I was in university when that song came out. But that song was fire. Woo! One of the most crispiest videos ever.
In the air, if you been broke, I see millionaires making bread. That's the end goal. Private jet, Benzo, can't see through the window. So if I die, I pray to God He bring me back a sin dope. Sin dope.
When I die, when I die, I hope that God will bring me back a sin dope. Yo, let me see if I heard that.
Benzo, can't see through the window. So if I die, I pray to God He bring me back a sin dope.
When I die, I pray to God that brings me back a sin dope. The guy who just gave the speech. Yo, man. That's deep. If that's deep. Now my... It's nice to make reference to the person because who just gave the speech and just explain their journey, you know, since 11 years old as friends. And the fact that he looked up to that, I mean, seemed dope, cool guy, but he looks like just a guy who's not industry. He doesn't look industry to me. And so for someone that's industry, like AKA megastar, to look at someone who look as normal, maybe the guy has accolades of his own, but he's not in the entertainment industry, so he's not considered a celebrity, and say, I want to come back as that guy. That, you don't know. I don't think you guys realize how powerful and deep that is, man.
Sin dope, 9/11 rims spoke. Back when it was college, I would hook him up with Craig notes. Teachers say he got a problem dealing with
back in college, I was hooking him up with crib notes. That's what he just said. Okay, so that's what that lyric meant.
When it was college, I would have came up with crib notes. DJ say he got a problem dealing with the tempo. But you ain't even fucking with his gym clothes. Don't see the
You ain't even fucking with the same clothes. So the guy was looking dapper in them clubs. But he went nice, but he was not doing that good at school.
Dealing with the tempo.
Real friends talking about.
But you ain't even fucking with his gym.
Actually, now that I'm listening to this, to this song that is dedicated to a friend, I'd like to dedicate this reaction to a friend of mine, David Matabane. Happy birthday, my guy. You've inspired me so much. You've done such a lot for me without even knowing, of course. But just your presence, man, knowing that I can rely on you and just, call you and chat to you and just to hear your voice and let you call me whenever you feel like you need to call me. Man, those moments are powerful and they mean a lot to me. And you.
Don't see the roof. That's German auto. JC the roof. 1,000 bottles. I see the truth. This the land of promise. Call me the proof. I'm just being honest.
This beat was crazy.
Hands in the air if you been broke. I see millionaires making bread, that's the end goal. Private jet Benzo, can't see through the window. So if I die, I pray to God he bring me back a sim. Sometimes I look at my mother, I think of what could have been. Imagine building a palace that's only fit for a queen. My daddy climbed up the ladder until he ran out of
man. And I believe this guy did build a home for his mother. I don't even have to Google that, because that's how real Keenan was, man. And the love that he's had for his parents, you can see in his, you can hear it in his music. And now you can see them, putting him to rest, that they love the guy.
The reputation was damaged, but never ran out of dreams. That's why I talk in my sleep. Fortunately, my esteem is awkward for people who awfully talkative in the street. Especially if all the talking is cheap. I got the recipe, making peace with my enemies. My conscience is clean. Oh, don't see the roof. That's German auto. JC the roof. 1,000 bottles. I see the truth. This the land of promises.
You know, I'm just feeling nostalgic now, but I'm just gonna let this go. Can you see the roof? The champagne's up. Nice.
Hands in the air if you've been broke. I see millionaires making bread, that's the end goal. Private jet Benzo, can't see through the window. So if I die, I pray to God he bring me back a sim dope. I'm in this bitch with Mandela. They pull my name out the envelope. You should fuck with the winners. You got some buzz when you're single, but that's just luck for beginners. I'm coming back in another life just to stunt on your children.
I'm coming back in another life just to stunt on your children. That's big flex.
Drop top for the summertime. Proposing this toast. Focused on goals like I'm number 9. Every one of these flows, my foes gon' analyze. Eyes closed while I fantasize. Nice clothes and my jewelry ice cold like Savannah Drive. Power moves being strategized. So if I die, I'm leaving behind some real dough. Or bring me back a sim dope. Still hope. Hands in the air if you been broke. I see millionaires making bread, that's the end goal. Private jet Benzo, can't see through the window. So if I die, I pray to God he bring me back a sim dope.
Yeah man, this song still claps. So many years later, it still claps. I'm glad that I reacted to it on this channel. That used to be my favorite song. I believe that it still is, because I still enjoy it till this day. And yeah, man, RIP to AKA, rest in peace, Super Manga. You were the real one. You were a real artist, a real MC, a real rapper, a real human being. I believe that you really had a genuine heart, and all those who are close to you, they're gonna miss you dearly, but I'm gonna trust that they're gonna keep your legacy to continue, and they're gonna celebrate you, man, because you were that guy. You were that guy. Anyway, that's it for me today. Hope you guys enjoy this reaction. See you on my next video. Peace.